Good morning, students. Today we are going to restart the lesson, Manufacturing Industries, lesson number 13, Agro-based Industries. We are today going to discuss 252 and 253 pages, all the basic points of the textile industries. The objectives we have covered so far are introduction, need for rapid industrialization, factors affecting the location of industries, and classification of industries. Before we start with today's topic, let's discuss some cross questions. My first cross question is, on the basis of management, how are the industries classified? Second, name the oldest private sector industry of India. Third, who controls the public sector industries? Number four, name some public sector industries. Number five, name some public sector companies. Number six, how are the joint sector industries managed? And name a industry falls under this. Number seven, how are the cooperative sector industries managed? Number eight, name the oldest cooperative sector industry of India. Number nine, name some large scale industries. 10, name some medium scale industries. And number 11, name some small scale industries. Please try to find out the answers of these questions and revise them also for your knowledge. Let's see some new words. Free trade zone, a port or area where the traders need not to pay any taxes or customs duty. Scarcity, shortage. Obsolete, outdated or old. Inadequate, not sufficient. Power loom, a mechanized loom. Now let's start with today's topic. Our today's topic or objective is overall view or overall points about the textile industry. If we are talking about textile industry, broadly speaking, textile includes five fibers. One is cotton, got from cotton yarn. Number second is jute, which we get from the jute yarn. Number three, wool. Number four, silk. Both these yarns we get from the animals. And next is synthetic fiber. These are the five basic textile which includes when we speak textile. Now the textile sector occupies an important place in terms of employment as it gives a lot of people employment. Many people are engaged in the textile industries all over India. Number two, it is the oldest among the manufacturing industries. Number three, at present, cotton textile manufacture is the largest organized modern industry in India. Let's start with the reading of the textile industries. Agro-based. Textile is a broad term which includes all five fibers. Cotton, jute, wool, silk, and synthetic fiber. The textile industry of India is the first manufacturing industry in India. The textile sector occupies an important place in terms of employment generation. It is the oldest among the modern manufacturing industries. At present, cotton textile manufacture is the largest organized modern industry in India. The industry has developed all over India, but the largest number of mills are situated in Maharashtra, Gujarat, and Tamil Nadu. Now we will see what are the main reasons for concentration of the industry in these states are due to the following points. Number one, availability of black cotton soil for growing cotton. Number two, humid climate suitable for cotton industry. which doesn't allow the thread to break easily. Next number, cheap hydroelectric power is easy available. International ports to import raw material and export finished goods. Skilled and unskilled labor drawn from surrounding areas. Ready market is available for finished goods. The areas are connected with hinterland by roads and railways. And banking facility is easy available and which plays an important role for setting up an industry. Maharashtra is often called the cotton polish of India. Tamil Nadu is often called the Manchester of India. The other important states are West Bengal. In West Bengal, Kolkata is the most important center. Uttar Pradesh, Kanpur is the largest center. Other centers are Moradabad, Lucknow, Modinagar, Agra and Saharanpur. Other states known for cotton industries are Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Kerala, Karnataka in south, Punjab, Haryana and Rajasthan in north. Now we will discuss why Maharashtra is one of the most important cotton textile industrial place in India. Maharashtra. Maharashtra is the most important cotton cloth producing state in our country. It produces nearly 40% of the milk cloth in India. Nearly 3 lakh workers are engaged in this industry in the state. It is often called cotton polish of India. Now in Maharashtra, Mumbai is the most important center and the major factors contributing to the concentration of in Maharashtra, Mumbai is the most important center and the major factor contributing to the concentration of textile industry in and around Mumbai are number 1. Black cotton soil in the hinterland of Mumbai, which provides cotton as a basic raw material. Humid climate. Offshore-based Mumbai, which is ideal for this industry as the thread does not break so easily. Number 3. Cheap hydroelectric power, which is available from Tata Hydroelectric Grid from Western Ghats. Mumbai's location as an international port, which helps in import of long staple cotton and machinery and export of finished goods. Long staple cotton are the cotton which are very good for manufacturing costly cotton items and which is mostly getting from Saudi Arabian countries. Skilled and unskilled labor, which can be drawn from the surrounding areas. The existence of a ready market for the finished products both in India and abroad. Mumbai is well connected with the hinterland by roads and railways. Abundant supply of soft water for dyeing and bleaching for coloring the cotton cloths and cotton yarn. Banking facility is easily available. Proximity to the Middle East means proximity means nearness. Nearness to Middle East, which has a good market for Indian cloth. Suez Canal played a very important role in this region, was made accessible for faraway countries because Suez Canal connects two major water bodies. One, Arabian Sea along with Atlantic Ocean. This we get the markets of European countries also, as well as we are accessible to American countries also. Mumbai also had an advantage of an early start, being the oldest among all other industries. Apart from Mumbai, the other centers of the cotton industry are Solapur, Pune, Kolhapur, Nagpur, Aurangabad, and Jalgaon. All these are in Maharashtra. Next is Gujarat. Gujarat is the second largest producer of cotton textile in India. It accounts for nearly 23% of the mill cloth production. Ahmedabad is the largest center where 73 out of 118 mills of Gujarat are located. Now we will see the factors responsible for concentration of textile industry in Ahmedabad are. Ahmedabad is situated right in the center of the cotton producing area, hence raw cotton is readily available. It has a humid climate which is ideal for cotton thread. Third, it has an advantage of both Kandla Free Trade Zone and Mumbai for export and import. These are well connected by roads and rail to Ahmedabad. Most of the Ahmedabad mills produce cheap cloth, which finds ready market among the poor masses of India. Cheap hydroelectric power is easily available. The other important centers of Gujarat are Vadodara, Surat, Rajkot, Porbandar, Morbi, and Bhavnagar. Tamil Nadu. Tamil Nadu is an important cotton textile producer. Although Tamil Nadu produces only 6% of the mill cloth of India, the state excels in yarn production and accounts for nearly one-third of the total yarn production of the country. It is often called Manchester of South India, means Tamil Nadu produces one-third of the cotton yarn which is used in the cotton mills. Tamil Nadu mills are smaller in size and hence give less production. The important centers are Coimbatore, Madurai, Salem, Tirunelveli, Tiruchirappalli, Tuticorin, and Ramanathapuram. Next is West Bengal. Kolkata is the most important textile center of West Bengal. It enjoys the facilities of being a major port, having humid climate, coal from Raniganj, local labor supply, and large demand of cotton cloth. It has an excellent network of roads and railways. Water is available from Hooghly River. Uttar Pradesh. Most of the cotton textile industry has developed along the western part of Uttar Pradesh. Kanpur is the largest center. Other centers are Moradabad, Lucknow, Modi Nagar, Itawa, Agra, and Saharanpur. Other states known for cotton industry are Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Kerala, Karnataka in south. In north, Punjab, Haryana, and Rajasthan are the important centers where cotton textile industries are set up. Now let's discuss some problems of cotton textile industry. The first and the most important point is scarcity of raw materials. For producing finished goods, raw material supply is not adequate in factories. That means the raw materials are less and they are not reaching to the factories in time. Obsolete machinery. Obsolete means old. Most of the mills have old machineries being 20 to 30 years old as compared to a life of 10 years. This gives low productivity. Number 3, inadequate power supply. With increasing population, problem of power supply is acute and this affects the productivity of the mills. Next point is low productivity of labor. Labor productivity is very low in India as compared to advanced countries. When the people, the workers who are there for manufacturing units, they give low productivity. Their work process is slow as compared to other advanced countries. Stiff competition. Indian textile has to face a stiff competition from power loom. Power loom means the clothes which are made from the machines and synthetic fibers. Sick mills. In India, 177 mills going in loss and declared as sick mills means old. They can't manufacture anything. For this, the National Textile Corporation has been set up to solve this problem. And since then, the corporation, National Textile Corporation, has taken up over 125 sick mills under them. Now we are going to discuss the problems of the cotton textile industry. Although cotton textile is the most important industry, it suffers from various problems. Some of the most important problems are scarcity of raw material. When the raw material supply is not adequate, means not proper, or then the scarcity of the raw material is there. Obsolete machinery. Most of the mills have obsolete, means old machinery, being 20 to 30 years old, as compared to an average life of about 10 years in other developed countries. This has resulted in low productivity and inferior quality. Inadequate power supply. With increasing population, the problem of power supply is becoming acute and the industry suffers from shortage of power. Low productivity of labor. Labor productivity is extremely low in India as compared to other advanced countries. Stiff competition. Indian cotton textile has to face stiff competition from power loom and synthetic fiber products, sick mills. All the above factors put together have resulted in about 177 mills going in loss and hence have been declared as sick mills. The National Textile Corporation was set up to solve the problems of the sick mills and has since taken over about 125 sick mills to look after them and to get the manufacturing done. Thank you very much, children. We have completed with the cotton textile industry. Do the questions which are behind related to cotton textile industry and reread cotton textile industry one more time for your better understanding. Thank you.